In this lab demonstration, we're going to learn about encrypting disks with customer-supplied encryption keys. By default, Compute Engine encrypts all data at rest. Compute Engine handles and manages this encryption for you without any additional action on your part. However, if you wanted to control and manage this encryption yourself, you can provide your own encryption keys. Our objectives with this demonstration are to create an encryption key and wrap it with the Compute Engine RSA public key certificate. We will then encrypt a new persistent disk with our own key, attach the disk to a Compute Engine instance, and create a snapshot from the encrypted disk. When using customer-supplied encryption keys, you will normally use some third-party tooling to create and manage and rotate your keys. For the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just generate a key by using a random number. So first, I'll use the OpenSSL command to generate a random number that I can use as a key. Next, I'm going to protect my new key with RSA key wrapping. This is an optional step to wrap our new key using an RSA public key certificate provided by Google, and then use that wrapped key in our requests. RSA key wrapping is a process in which you use a public key to encrypt your data. After that data has been encrypted with the public key, it can only be decrypted by the respective private key. In this case, the private key is known only to Google Cloud Services. So by wrapping our key using the RSA certificate, we can ensure that only Google Cloud Services can unwrap our key, and then we can use that to protect our data. So first I need to download the Compute Engine public certificate. Now I'll extract the public key from the certificate with the OpenSSL command. Now I will RSA wrap my original key. Finally, my new key must now be encoded in Base64 before it can be used. Now I can view my encoded and RSA wrapped key. And it's ready to use. I'll need to copy the entire key to my clipboard. This can be tricky in the Cloud Shell sometimes because it may include the new line. So I'm also going to open this key in the Cloud Shell editor. Next, I'm going to create a new persistent disk, and I'm going to use my new key as the encryption key for that disk. Under the encryption section, I'll choose customer-supplied encryption key and paste in my new Base64 encoded and wrapped key. Finally, I'll check this box to let Compute Engine know that this is a wrapped key. Then I'll click Create. So now I'm going to create a Compute Engine instance, and I'll attach my new encrypted disk. Here, I need to provide my own key again, so that Compute Engine can decrypt and use the disk. And again, I'll check this box to specify that this is a wrapped key. Then I'll click Create to create the VM. And now my VM has launched, and it has two disks attached, its boot disk and my new encrypted disk. The encrypted disk still needs to be formatted and mounted to my instance's operating system. First, I'll use the makefs command to create the file system. And then I'll create a new directory and mount my disk into that directory. The disk is now mounted and ready to be used. Finally, let's see how we can create a snapshot from an encrypted disk. When using customer-supplied encryption keys, we cannot create differential snapshots, so snapshots of encrypted disks are always full snapshots. So first I'll provide a name for my snapshot, and then I'll choose my source disk. Because the disk that we're snapshotting is encrypted, I once again have to provide my encryption key and specify that this is a wrapped key. Then I need to specify a key to encrypt my snapshot. Note that snapshots can be encrypted with a different key than their source disk, but for the purposes of this demo, I'll just use the same key. Now I've successfully created a snapshot of my encrypted disk. That concludes this demonstration.